Let's all play What's My Line?
Hello, everybody.
Hello, Larry.
Welcome to Tuesday.
Why, thank you, Larry.
It is nice to see you all. We have some marvelous challengers who will baffle and mystify you.
We'll be
mystery guests yet later who will puzzle you altogether. Right now, would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Would our first or second challenger enter and sign in, please? Would our first, second, or third challenger enter? There we go. Rudi Stern.
Hey, Rudy.
Where are you from, Rudi?
New York City.
New York City. All right, panel. Rudi Stern owns an art gallery that specializes in a form of vanishing Americana that you may not consider fine art, but nevertheless. Now, we'll show the audience what Mr. Stern's gallery specializes in. And let's start the questioning with Joanna Barnes.
Was this art form, Mr. Stern, in its original, something that one could buy in a store?
One down and nine to go, I would think.
No.
Soupy, anything can be bought in a store, but you wouldn't go to the store to buy it in that sense. Now, Soupy?
And it's a vanishing art.
Mm-hmm.
when it's seen, is it ever seen, is it out where people can see it?
Mm-hmm. Yes. It's designed so that people can see it.
Yeah. Oh, don't help him. He'll take it and run like a pickpocket.
Pay no attention to him, Rudi. You go right ahead and see it. So if you walk down the street, you would see this?
You could.
Yes.
You'll see less and less of it. You see.
That's it. That's playing it cool, Rudi. Soupy?
You see less and less of it. Yeah. Sounds like my agent. is it some kind of a artwork that is used in, say, outdoor advertising?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Is it some kind of I think of a vanishing art, like that guy, I don't even know if it's down there, that guy that blows the smoke out of the on the billboard.
Blows the smoke rings and
that type of thing where some smoke comes out, or you know, like the, I think it was the Camel Man or something.
Yeah, that was it. No, that's not it. Yeah. Two down, eight to go. Gail,
would this be found outside?
Mm-hmm.
Is it?
Could be.
Made of wood?
No.
Three down, seven to go. Alan.
I take it we've established it is some form of outdoor advertising.
It could be.
Can be.
Can be. Is it, does it have any metal on it any place?
Well, some place, I imagine there's some. Hmm?
Some places.
Okay. Yes.
But it,
are they, is it...
There isn't a dominant aspect of it, though.
Gotcha. Is it some kind of billboard?
Not really.
No.
Four down, six to go, Joanna.
Is this outdoor advertising perhaps something like a sandwich sign?
Five down and five to go,
no.
Soupy.
Is this outdoor thing, is it ever, when you see it, was it ever in different colors? In different colors?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Is it anything that would it be ever made or contain anything that, like glass?
Yes.
And it lights up? It's neon?
Neon sign.
That's fabulous.
Rudi is co-founder of Let There Be Neon. It's an art gallery just opened in downtown New York in Soho, and it's devoted exclusively to neon signs. Yeah, Joanna, what?
Well, why is it vanishing? Yeah. I don't understand.
It's a craft that's dying year by year.
Really?
And a lot of the old craftsmen have stopped working with it.
Oh,
that's
for
now, you collect. You have old signs there and then new ones
old
also.
Old signs and new signs.
Some that you design.
Home fixtures made of neon.
Did you bring some with you?
Yes, I did.
Could we open the curtain, Lloyd, and see some of the signs that he has?
Oh!
just think that stuff is smashing. Now, the big round one there that says, "Let There Be Neon," is that one that you designed?
That's a logo for our gallery.
I see. Now, as we move across from Let There Be Neon, that's the new one. That's an old one then, of course.
Right.
All right, and then we're coming up on Irving's Kosher Delicatessen, I guess, huh?
Right.
How much is that sign?
Selling for $200 at the gallery with a transformer.
Isn't that, now there's another one. That's Isaac Gelly's Delicatessen. Is that more?
Same price.
Oh, now hold it, what is that, a phone coming in?
Yeah, the sculpture at the right is a home multiple. It's a table sculpture.
I see. Now, in the back, there's a tree and a one-hour sign. Are those old ones?
Yeah.
Are they the same sign?
They're about 15 years old, and they're both different signs.
I see. What was the one-hour, pressing or something?
From a dry cleaning store.
Now, what's that down there, a tree or
a mushroom.
A mushroom?
Right.
You designed that one,
then,
huh?
Yes, I did.
Okay, let's move across and see what else. That's a flower.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what does that sell for, Rudi?
The flower, $100.
Boy, flower. That's really...
Now, the drug sign is also yours, I guess. Or
right.
Is that an old one?
No, that's a new sign.
Well, look at that. It can go on and off if it wants to, huh? That's sensational, like those signs outside. Let's move across and see what... Oh, there's a rainbow. Now, you do that one, sure.
Right.
How much is the rainbow?
$125.
That really is... And then that's another mushroom there, huh?
Right.
Isn't that marvelous? Look at those things. Now, you use them in your house just as lighting or as...
I live with a lot of them. I've had about 20 or 30 at home, and friends have seen them, and they've started buying them and collecting them. And I've turned on a lot of people just to collecting neon.
They're really marvelous. Could you use them for a nightlight or something like
sure,
that?
Sure, sure.
They're really terribly attractive, Rudi. Congratulations, and thank you for being with us on What's My Art.